Hello, I'm Susie Johns, and today I'm going to be making some artists' trading cards using backgrounds that I painted with watercolours in a previous video. Artists' trading cards are just small paintings or drawings, usually 3.5 by 2.5 inches. And lots of people around the world make them and trade them with each other, do swaps, or some people use them as business cards, just a small example of their larger works. They're also great fun to make. So let's get started. So here's a selection of the watercolour backgrounds that I've painted previously. And it's nice to just spend a session making these, and when they're dry, putting them away for when you're ready to make your cards. So I'll just run through the things I'll be using to make these cards: a pair of scissors, the painted watercolour backgrounds, some little bits of collage material that I've snipped from old comics and books, some glue, that's the PVA glue, and a brush, some little ink pads and rubber stamps. There's a rubber stamp there, there's a pencil with a rubber on the end and an ordinary pencil rubber. A craft knife and steel ruler, a little cutting mat. There's some jewels I might stick on at the end. And there's some pens, some paint pens and Sharpies for adding some detail. So we'll start with two of the backgrounds. These are quite plain, just watercolour wash backgrounds. And I'm dipping the end of the pencil, the rubber on the end of the pencil, into the ink stamp pads and stamping little circles just to create a bit of pattern. And for the other piece, I've got a pencil eraser here that I've just cut away some of one end, to make a small rectangle. And I'm going to use it to print a brick wall. So I've got red, orange, sort of burnt orange and brown. And I'm dipping the stamp in each of them sort of fairly randomly, to create this sort of brickwork effect, which I think looks quite effective. While I've got those colours out, I think I'll just use the end of the pencil again to make another dotty background. Now I'll use a little rubber stamp and a black ink pad just to turn this plain blue painted background into something a bit more interesting. And then these four rubber stamped backgrounds will be ready to add some collage to make the first batch of four cards. So it's time to choose a few little paper cutouts and to stick them on to the backgrounds. For this I'm using a PVA glue and making sure that I brush it right up to the edges of the cutout, of the back of the cutout, to make sure that it's firmly stuck in place, and then brushing over it again with more glue. I'm brushing it with some more PVA just to make sure it's really, really, really well sealed. I hope you've enjoyed watching this tutorial as much as I've enjoyed making it, and that you'll make your own batch of artist trading cards if you haven't done already. I've put together some materials, some packs of papers for collage, mostly from vintage books and comics and magazines, and I'll put them up for sale in my Etsy shop. So do check the description below for details of that. And I'll put pictures of the finished artist trading cards on my Instagram, and details of that are in the description too. Thank you.